Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A very warm welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan, where we have a very interesting topic today. One of which I think we're going to be having many is Japan in the run-up to the 2020 Olympics in Tokyo. But today, as you know, our subject is on a game that's quite close to my heart in terms of the grief it's caused me, but golf. Before I begin, if I could just ask if everyone, if you have a cell phone, which I'm sure everyone does, can you please either turn it off or mute it so as we're not interrupted during the speech today. We have three speakers, and of course, as I said, this issue is about golf and in specifically the venue that has been chosen for the golf tournament in the 2020 Olympics, which we're given to understand is the Kasumigaseki Country Club, an exclusive club, which again we're given to understand does not extend memberships to women. The argument of our speakers today is that this is quite contrary to the spirit of the Olympic Games. Our speakers are Eiko Ohya, who's the chairwoman of the Japan Golf Council, Yutaka Morohoshi, who's the vice chairman and professor of the Graduate School of Oberlin University, and Masayuki Tamaki, who's a sports writer. We also have Mr. Shigefumi Matsuzawa, who's a former Kanagawa governor. He'll not be speaking, but he'll be here to take any questions during the Q&A. So our first speaker is Ms. Eiko Ohya. So if I could ask again, you can give a warm welcome to our speaker today. Thank you.
Domo minasama, kyou wa atakushi domo no, kore haitte masu? Haitte ta, shitsurei shimashita. 日本ゴルフ改革会議のプレスカンファレンスにお越しいただきましてありがとうございます。私は一応議長をしております大谷英子と申します。フリーランスのジャーナリストでありテレビのコメンテーターでありたくさんの政府の審議会委員などもやってまいりました。私は大変ん
Good afternoon. Thank you very much for joining us at this press conference. I am nominally serving as the chairwoman of the Japan Golf Council. I am also active as a freelance journalist, a commentator on television, and I have also been involved in various government committees as well.
ゴルフにハマって25年以上になります。ゴルフ大好き人間でございます。ゴルフの大好きなものとして今日本に置かれているゴルフの状況を考えてみんなで憂えて集まったのがこのゴルフ改革会議です。
I myself am very much a fan or enjoy playing golf. I have been playing golf for more than 25 years. And as someone who loves this sport, I have come together with other fellow golf players and fans in order to form this association, this council, to look at how we can make a change or make a reform to the situation of golf here in Japan.
ゴルフが衰退の一途をたどっておりまして、ゴルフ場がどんどん太陽光発電になってしまうとかですね、ゴルフの人口もどんどん減ってるっていう形、それプラスゴルフがずっと贅沢なものとして差別され続けてきたっていう状況があります。皆さんご存知のようにゴルフをすると利用税っていうのを取られるわけ。バスケット利用税とかテニス利用税なんて聞いたことはない。ゴルフだけは利用税を取られる。もう一つすごいのが、公務員倫理法っていうのがありまして、公務員は、利益関係になる可能性がある人とゴルフをしてはならぬとわざわざゴルフとメンションしてあるわけですね。そんなことをされて、夏休みにあれだけたくさんの回数総理大臣がやるスポーツをですね、そういう扱いにしていいものかというふうに、基本的には思っています。さっきゴルフをやる人の中、ごめんなさい。
すいません。 In recent years, golf has been somewhat fading as a sport here in Japan. We are seeing many golf courses around the country being turned, for example, into solar power farms. Also, many the number of people involved in the sport in Japan, the golf population has also been decreasing. In relation to this is the fact that golf is seen somewhat as a luxury sport here in Japan, and it has therefore been discriminated against. Perhaps some of you may be familiar, but there is actually a usage tax which is employed or put in place in regards to golf, which is not actually in place at all for any other sports. You not hear any such thing, for example, for basketball. However, golf is actually the target of such discrimination. Also, there is a law in Japan known as the National Public Service Ethics Act, and actually this act specifically mentions golf as a sport which those in the public service field are not allowed to be engaged in. However, when we look at the situation where the Prime Minister of Japan, of course, is playing golf so many times during the summer vacation, is this really how a sport of this caliber in Japan should be treated?
今ゴルフが大好きです。する人ばっかりと思われたかもしれませんが、ここにいる玉木さんはゴルフ全然やりません。3回だけハワイでやったことがあるって、それなのにこの運動に参加してくださっています。で、私ここに集まっている人はみんな個人で手弁当でおか未然を切って、これからの日本におけるゴルフをもっと楽しいものにして、もっとみんなが、アクセシブルになって、ゴルフが広がっていくことを望んで、集まっているものです。
You may have the impression that those of us involved in the Japan Golf Council or up here today are all very much fans and involved in the sport. However, actually, Mr. Tamaki himself has only played golf 3 times in his life in Hawaii, actually. Therefore, we are not just here as golf players, but as individuals contributing voluntarily with our own expenses and funds to form this council to look at how we can make golf more enjoyable and also more accessible for people here in Japan and to spread the sport in this way.
でどうにかそう何かいろんなできることを考えて、対外的に、提言をしてまいりました。
And therefore, we have been considering what we can do to contribute this and making recommendations, therefore.
でその中の一つとして、オリンピックが浮上してきました。
And it was in this context that the issue of the Olympics arose.
私もスポーツ大好きなので、オリンピックが大好きなんですが、21世紀のオリンピック、まあ、2020年のオリンピックっていうのは今までのものとは違う、何か違う形のものにするべきだと思うし、できるというふうにも思っています。
When we look at, and as someone who does love sports, what kind of Olympics we should be having in the 21st century or in the year 2020, I believe that it's very important to have something which is different to what it has been until now, a new form of Olympics for this age.
で新しいオリンピック、やっぱりもう皆さん世界中で言ってるわけです。コンパクトであることと、それからレガシー、まあ、この他にもいろいろあとのメンバーが説明しますが、私その2つだけちょっと申し上げたいんですが、もうお金をいっぱい使ってなんかすごいことをやろうっていう大きなものはいいことだなっていう時代ではないというふうに思います。
And for when we are looking at this concept of what a new Olympics should be, there are two particular aspects which I would like to speak about. The first is about being a compact Olympics, and the second is what kind of legacy can be left as part of these Olympics. There are, of course, many other issues which my fellow speakers will be touching on, but I would like to focus on these two. We are no longer in the age where just investing a whole lot of money into something and making as big as possible is the way forward. It is a different time now.
今そのゴルフ場をどこでやるかということに対しての問題になっているわけですが、私たちが推薦している若洲というのは、選手村からほんの6キロです。すごく近いわけです。で霞は50キロ60キロ44キロ、
直線で
ね、
道路を取ると70キロ
だそうですね。
And now the issue of where to hold the golf tournament during the 2020 Olympics is becoming an issue which we are speaking about today. We are proposing that the venue be held at Wakasu Golf Links, which is located a mere 6 kilometers from the Olympic Athletes Village. The Kasumigaseki Country Club, where the golf tournament is currently planned, is in a direct line as the crow flies 44 kilometers from the Athletes Village, or 70 kilometers by road.
で若洲が21世紀らしいっていうのは、若洲がある今ゴルフ場があるところはもともとはゴミの山でした。
One of the further reasons for which Wakasu is very much suited to a 21st century contemporary Olympics is the fact that it is located on what actually used to be a rubbish dump.
で、できたての頃はですね、こう 地中からこう 煙突が出ておりまして、こうガスメタンガスが出るんですね。で火がついちゃうと火事になるので、ゴルフ場でタバコ吸ってはいけないというルールがあったぐらいなんです。
And at the time when the golf links were first built there, actually, because they still had chimneys left over from the rubbish dump, this meant that actually there was methane gas in the area, meaning that players were not allowed to light cigarettes in the area because of the danger of fire.
で、その頃のイメージが強くて、それから狭くて短くてって、世界からのお客様を迎えるのにふさわしくないっていうことをおっしゃる方がいますが、もうすっかりマチュアードのいいゴルフ場に今はなっております。
And therefore many people are left with the image of the golf course in its initial days, being also perhaps not large enough or also a very short course, and therefore not suitable for welcoming international guests for such a tournament. However, in fact, in the years since that time, it has matured very much into a very suitable, impressive golf course.
で、簡単にそのティーグラウンドを下げることによって7300まで伸ばすことは可能です。
It is also possible by a simple extension of the tee ground area to extend the total length of the golf course to 7,300 yards.
で、もう一つ重要なことはですね、ワカスは、パブリックで東京都が持っております。霞は超高級プライベートクラブで、普通の人はできません。メンバーの紹介がない限りプレーはできません。で、さっき司会の方がおっしゃったように、女性は正会員になれない、日曜日にはプレーできないということ、正会員になれないということは、いろいろな意思決定に参画できないということですね。
And one further important distinction between the courses is the fact that Wakasu Golf Links is a public course, which is owned by the Tokyo Metropolitan Government. In comparison to this, the course at Kasumigaseki is a very exclusive, high-class membership club. It is in the case where, for example, normal people are not able to enter this. In order to play on the club, you need an introduction of a full member. And as was briefly introduced as well, in fact, women are not able to become full regular members of the club. They are also not permitted to play on Sundays. As a result, also not being full members of the club, this means they cannot also be involved in the management decisions and operations of the club.
ですからオリンピックが終わった後でワカスでしたら全ての人にそのプレーするチャンスが開かれていますが、霞ヶ関ですといくらオリンピックのあったところでやりたいなって言っても知り合いにメンバーがいなかったらプレーはできないという状況になっています。
Therefore, if we consider this fact, after the Olympics have finished, anybody from the public would be able to play on Wakasu Golf Course if indeed they were interested to go ahead and have the chance to play golf on this Olympic course. However, in the case of Kasumi, Kasumigaseki Country Club, even if a member of the public wanted to experience this Olympic golf course without the introductional connection to a member, this would not be possible.
それともう一つ追加したいのは、オリンピックと並行してパラリンピックが行われるのが通例ですが、今ゴルフはパラリンピック入っていませんけれども、霞はその自分オリンピックの、会場という話があったときに、直ちに自分たちはパラリンピックはできないということを表明しています。ワカスの方はもうすでに全部バリアフリーになっておりまして、いつでもパラリンピックの、ことがゴルフができるようになっています。
And one further point to add is in regards to the Paralympics. At the moment, golf is not included as a sport within the Paralympics. However, at the time of the announcement of Kasumigaseki as a venue, they immediately expressed the fact that they would not be able to host any Paralympic sports, that this would not be possible. And if we compare, Wakasu is actually a completely so-called barrier-free or accessible course. Therefore, if there were a decision made for the Paralympics to also include golf, Wakasu would be able to host them at any time.
世界中で環境問題が大変なイシューになっているときに、ゴミの山から、ゴルフ場を作ったっていうのは、世界に誇れる私は、グッドサンプルだというふうに思っておりますし、そのレガシーということに関して、やっぱりどう考えても若すの方がいいのではないかというふうに確信しております。
If we consider that environmental issues are of great concern around the world today, the fact that a golf course was created on what was formerly a rubbish dump is indeed a good best practice sample of which Japan can be proud to the world. Also, in regards to the legacy issue, I am very certain that Wakasu is indeed superior in this regard.
この後、2人に もう少し広げて話をしてもらおうと思います。Morohoshi さんどうぞお願いします。
So I would like to pass over now to Mr. Morohoshi to speak about some broader issues in relation.
はい、ありがとうございます。まずいくつか問題点を私どもがポイントアウトしたいんですけれども、一つは、霞が関に決まったその決定のプロセスであります。
I would like to point out several issues, the first of which is in regards to the decision-making process which led to Kasumigaseki being confirmed as the venue.
東京がやることですから、当然のこととして若洲がはじめは、まあ、第一候補ということになっておりました。ところが急にその名前は消えてしまって、そしてある日突然Kasumigaseki になったと。
Of course, as the Olympics are being hosted by Tokyo, it was natural that Wakasu Golf Links was first named as one of the potential venues for golf during the Olympics. However, at some stage during this process, all of a sudden the name of Wakasu disappeared and a sudden decision was made to announce the golf venue at Kasumigaseki.
オリンピックのベニューを決めるのはその国のナショナルフェデレーション NF と言いますけれども、各スポーツ団体、例えば体操だったら日本体操協会、バスケットボールだったら日本バスケットボール協会が答申を受けて、そして、オリンピック日本のオリンピック委員会もしくは組織委員会にこの候補この場所でやりたいというふうに出すわけですけれども、ゴルフの場合の NF 日本の委員会は、JGA 日本ゴルフ協会でございます。
In regards to the decision-making process for an Olympic venue, it is the usual practice for the national federation of each sport to make a nomination for where the venue should be held. So, for example, the National Gymnastics or Basketball Association of Japan, and this would therefore be put towards to the preparatory or the Japan Olympic Committee or organizing committee. In the case of golf, the national federation which is associated with this is the JGA or the Japan Golf Association.
The JGA のまあ、基本的な非常にうがった見方かもしれませんけれども、密室で話された、そしてそれに参加された方々というのは圧倒的大多数が霞ヶ関カントリークラブのメンバーでございます。
And it may be a somewhat blunt way to put this, however, an overwhelming number of the members of the JGA and therefore those people who were involved in the decision-making process for the venue are in fact members of the 霞ヶ関カントリークラブ。
確かにいくつかのクライテリアといいますか、こう要件をですね出して、そしてこう審査の過程を踏んだとはされてるんですけれども、例えばですよ、36ホールなくてはいけないという一つの要件を出されました。ゴルフ18ホールあればできるんです。36ある必要ないんです。
There are, of course, several criteria which were put forward in regards to the decision-making process for the venue. However, the process in regards to this is something which needs attention. For example, one of the criteria which was put forward is that 36 holes were required for the venue for the Olympics. However, in fact, 8 holes is actually enough to 18. conduct. 18. Sorry, 18 holes is enough to conduct a full golf tournament.
ということで、まあ、その他にもですね、2つは株式会社が経営している。そしてあとの2つは、社団法人が経営して、そういう4つの候補を出したわけです。
And there were actually four different options which were put forward, which were managed, for example, by limited companies or also by other registered organizations.
で、その4つを出した理由というのは、明らかにその他の3つは自然に消えていくということが分かってて、まあ、デキレースという言葉ありますけれども、そういう感じの候補が出てまいりました。
However, actually at the time when these four different options were put forward, the decision making or the selection of them was very clearly in order to automatically exclude three of these options from this race and therefore naturally lead to one particular decision.
ですから私どもはこのプロセスをですね、もう少し透明度を高くしてですね、本当の意味でのそのアカウンタビリティ、説明責任というものをですね、やはり都民、それから日本国民に示すべきだろうというふうに考えております。
Therefore, we believe that there is a requirement for more transparency and accountability in regards to this decision-making process, and indeed, this is needed to be accountable to the citizens of Tokyo and of Japan.
もう少し、実務的なといいますか、実際のゴルフのベニューとして、どのくらい不便なことになるかということを考えてみたいんですが、先ほどの話にありましたように、片や6キロ、片や70キロということになりますと、まあ、世界の50決に入っているプロフェッショナルゴルファーが来てですね、あの辺のビジネスホテルには泊まりません。
I would next like to speak about some of the other practical considerations or reasons why the current venue at Kasamigaseki is indeed rather inconvenient. We mentioned the distance issue, so 6 kilometers in comparison to 70 kilometers. Also, when we need to consider the accommodation issue, when we think about the kind of business hotels which are available around the Kasamigaseki venue, well, professional golf players of top class from around the world are not going to stay in these kind of business hotels.
ということは、彼らはもしくは彼女らは都心の、まあ、高級ホテルに泊まるわけですけど、そこから霞が関にどうやって行くのかということなんですね。で現在、まあ、あのまことしやかに、まあ、噂がモアの噂だと思うんですけれどもがあるのは、首都高および、関越道の1レーンをオリンピックレーンとして借り切ると、これとんでもないお金でございます。
Therefore, if we consider the fact that the pro golfers would not be staying in business hotels around the Kasamigaseki venue, but instead staying at top class hotels in the Tokyo metropolitan area, we need to consider how would they be traveling back and forth to the golf course. There were some, well, I believe more than rumors, but comments being made at the beginning of this year that actually the Metropolitan Expressway and Kanetsu Expressway would actually have reserved Olympic lanes put aside for these transportation purposes. And this would, of course, involve a ridiculous amount of funds.
もちろん選手の警護、これも大変なことであります。それだけ、まあ、足が長いというか遠いところでやられますとですね、これはもう警護は警備のことは大変な問題になると思います。
Of course, there is also the issue of security for the players as well, because there would be such a significant distance between the accommodation and venue. This would incur also many considerations in regards to how to provide security for this area.
次の問題は、気候のことであります。天候、気候、温度のことであります。
The next issue is in regards to the climate, weather, or well, temperature.
こちらにおられる松田参議院が、まとめられて国会で提出された資料によりますと、過去5年間の平均3年間の平均気温をですね、霞ヶ関カントリークラブおよび若洲ゴルフリンクスで取りました。それによりますと霞ヶ関は35度という、一つのまあ完全なカットオフラインですけど、それをはるかに超えている温度が毎年平均温度としてですね、その7月の最後の週、もしくは8月の初めの週に記録されております。若洲はですね、やはりそれよりも数度下でありまして、しかも若洲の場合は海に面しております。全く海の上でゴルフやってるもんですから、もう風が、海風が来て体感温度は非常に低いです。
In regards to this, Mr. Matsuzawa has also presented data at the Diet showing the average temperature for the past 3 years in both of these two locations. Within this data, we can see that the average annual temperature for the time in which the tournament will be held, that is the last week of July or the first week of August, that the annual average at Kasumigaseki Country Club is 35 degrees. This is actually above what we would see as the cutoff line. In comparison, the Wakasu Golf Links is several degrees cooler than this. Also, the fact that it is located right next to the ocean means that the winds coming from the coast or from the ocean also makes the temperature feel even less than it actually is.
ここにありますけれども、霞ヶ関が 35.77、37.05、34.79 と3年間の平均が 35.87 と。これは選手はアスリートですので、まあ、多分大丈夫でしょう。ただ観客がもし仮に1万人来たら救急車100台必要になります。
The figures for the Kasumigaseki Country Club, we can see, is at, in the past 3 years, 35.77, 37.05, and so on. Within the annual temperature is actually 35.87 degrees Celsius over the past 3 years. Well, the athletes are, of course, professional, so maybe they would be all right in such temperatures. However, if we consider the fact that there may be audience of up to 10,000 people present at this venue, this would necessitate 100 ambulances being brought to the location in case.
まあ、1万人と申しましたけども、実は2万5000人という予測がされてますので、ということは救急車が250台ということで、そうすると道路がどうなるのかということにもなります。これは埼玉県が道路を作ってくれなくちゃならないわけで、埼玉県川越にあるわけですから、これは全くそのコストから考えてもですね、とんでもないことになってしまうんじゃないかというふうに考えます。
And I mentioned 10,000 people as a possible audience, but actually it is estimated that there will be about 25,000 people attending as audience members for the golf tournament during the Olympics. This would therefore mean an increase to 250 ambulances required for a crowd of that size. So what does this imply for the road situation in that area? Of course, the Saitama Prefecture, as the country club is located in Kawagoe, would have to also invest in roads and so on for that purpose, and this would lead to ridiculous costs.
まあ、ということで、私どもは対象表を作りまして、点数を、まあ、我々なりに、そしてさまざまなエキスパートの意見を聞いてですね、やったのですが、全くもう比較にならないくらい、爆発の方がいいんではないかという結論に達したわけでございます。
We have in this way put together, for example, some comparison graphs, including the temperature and these other aspects, also gathering opinions from various experts in relation to this. And as a result, we can see that, well, there is no comparison. The Wakasu Golf Links is very much a superior venue.
Kasumigaseki Country Club というのは日本を代表する本当に素晴らしいゴルフクラブであります、ゴルフ場であります。そして そこが大変なお金をかけて新たに、コースを改造されました。これはすごいコースであることは間違いありません。
Of course, the Kasumigaseki Country Club is a very excellent course and club which represents Japan internationally. And with the investment that is planned to renovate the course, it is certain that it would be a very wonderful golf course.
しかし本当にこれが日本のゴルフのために、これからのゴルフのために役に立つのかということを考えたときに、私どもはそういうふうに思いません。これ一番ベネフィットといいますか、まあ、利益というのはあまり好きな言葉ではありませんけれども、恩恵を受けるのは Kasumigaseki Country Club およびそこのメンバーの方々だけではないかというふうに私ども考えます。
However, despite the fact that the course itself may be of an excellent grade, is this really in the best interest or purpose for the Japanese golf world or the Japanese golfing from now as well? When we consider who would be reaping the benefits of holding it at Kasumigaseki Country Club, I believe that it is the club and its members who would indeed be on the receiving end of this.
ここで玉木副議長に補足をしていただきたいと思います。
So、I would like to now pass over to Vice Chair Mr. Tamaki.
こんにちは、玉木と申します。FCCJ に私がやってくるのは4回目でして、過去3回はプロ野球のこと、高校野球のこと、それと柔道の体罰問題のことでお邪魔しました。
Good afternoon. My name is Tamaki. This is my fourth occasion to speak here at the FCCJ. The three times beforehand were in regards to professional baseball, high school baseball, and also the issue of violence or punishment within judo.
私自身はゴルフをやりませんが、先ほど大谷議長が言われたように、ただハワイのマウナケアで波越えのホールで、グリーンにワンオンしております。
すごい。
As was mentioned before, I am myself not a golf player. However, on the occasions, three times when I have played a Mauna Kea in Hawaii, I actually had the occasion of having a...
それはさておき、オリンピック問題がいろいろある中で、ゴルフ場の問題というものもが出てきても、私自身がゴルフにあまり興味はなかったので、それほど大きな問題だとは思わなかったんです、最初は。
Initially, when the issue of the golf venue came up in regards to the Olympics, because I myself am not involved in the sport, I did not necessarily recognize the significance of this issue.
そんな中で、こういう雑誌を私は雑誌という冊子ですね、を手に入れたんですね。これは JK と言いまして、慶応高校の OB 会誌です。 で慶応高校および慶応大学を卒業した人のゴルフ関係者たちが4人集まって座談会をやっております。でその中で、この座談会のタイトルが2020年東京オリンピック、競技会場決定の舞台裏となっています。
However, at the time of these discussions, I happened to come across this magazine or booklet. It is entitled JK, and it is actually the magazine for alumni of the Keio High School. And in this, there was an article which features a discussion between these four people in the photograph. They are all alumni of Keio, either high school or university, involved in the golf world. And the title of this article is Bringing Back Golf in the Tokyo Olympics and the Behind the Scenes of the Decision Making of the Tournament Venue.
この中で組織委員会にも加わっておられる元電通の国際部長の方であるとか、ゴルフ解説者として高名な方であるとか、現在ゴルフ日本の JPG ですか、JGA ですねの会長となられた方であるとか、慶応OBの方が座談会で喋っておられる中で、やはり先ほど諸星さんが指摘されました36ホールなければいけないとか、あるいは20万人のギャラリーを入れるためには霞が関でなければならないというようなことを喋っておられます。
And within this, the four members who are involved in the discussion here feature, for example, people who are alumni of Keio, who are involved in the Japan Olympics Organizing Committee, also the former head of the International Department at Dentsu Advertising Agency, a well-known golf commentator, or also former chair of the Japan Golf Association. Within this discussion of the alumni from Keio, they are talking about the different criteria which were put forward, such as Mr. Morohoshi mentioned, the requirement for 36 holes, or also they are even saying the fact that a gallery which could hold a capacity of 200,000 people would be required, meaning that Kasumigaseki is the only possible venue.
で、この中でレガシーのことについては全く語られていません。それから、女性差別あるいは新商社差別のことについても全く喋っておられません。
However, within this discussion or the article, there is absolutely no mention to the legacy remaining from the Olympics. There is also no mention of discrimination against the women or also people who are differently abled.
そもそもオリンピックでゴルフが正式競技となった背景にはゴルフ人口の減少っていうのが世界的にありまして、それでゴルフをする人が増えるようにゴルフの人気が上がるようにというところでオリンピックの競技になったという経緯があります。
And actually, golf was only recently brought back as an official sport within the Olympics. And in the background to the decision to bring it back was the fact that globally there has been a decrease in the population of people playing golf. So there was an effort in order to look at how golf can once again have more people involved and bring back more popularity to the sport.
ですから、1996年のアトランタオリンピックの時に、あそこのオーガスタナショナルゴルフクラブです。でゴルフをオリンピック競技として復活させようという動きがありました。
There was actually a move to bring back golf as an official Olympic sport at the time of the 94 Atlanta Olympics, and the discussion then was in regards to the Augusta National Golf Club.
ところが当時のオーガスタは女人禁制のルールがあったためにオリンピック競技にはオリンピックの根本的な精神と合わない。ということで、オーガスタ側、あるいはアトランタ側が断念しているわけです。
However, at the time, the fact that the club at Augusta did not allow female members meant that it was designated as not being suited to the Olympic spirit or principles. Therefore, the Augusta or Atlanta side actually gave up on including including golf as an official sport. Sorry.
そのことを考えれば今回の東京2020年東京オリンピックで霞ヶ関カントリークラブを選ばれた過程も不思議ですし、また女性が政界になれないというルールがあるのに選んだ理由もわからないですし、それにパラリンピック身体障害者用の施設もないというところをオリンピックに選ぶのも分かりませんし、おまけに この額罰といえるような冊子にですね、あたかも自分たちが決めたような座談会が載っているような会場が選ばれていいのだろうかと、ということで私は、ゴルフが好きでもない人間にもかかわらず、この問題は大きな問題であるというふうに考えたわけです。
Therefore, when we consider the fact that the Kasumigaseki Country Club was selected as the venue for the golf tournament in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics, I believe that this process itself does seem rather strange. When we also think about the fact that a club which does not allow women as full regular members was selected, this is itself also something which is difficult to understand. Not only this, a club which also has no facilities for disabled persons as well, when we consider the spirit of the Olympics and Paralympics, is something very difficult to follow and to see, well, whether is this really something suitable for the Olympics. Not only this, but when we look at the discussion in this alumni magazine, for example, where these members are talking about it is in, well, we decided, or we were the ones that decided the venue for the Olympics, I really question whether this should be acceptable. So as someone who doesn't even like the sport of golf, I began to see this as a very big issue.
私はJGC というこのゴルフ改革会議に参加させていただいて、日本のゴルフの問題が日本の多くのスポーツの問題と共通していることに気づいたんです。
Being involved in the Japan Golf Council, the JGC, has made me realize that many of the issues in relation to golf in Japan today are also held in common with other sports in Japan.
例えば全日本選手権、柔道ですね、柔道の全日本選手権は男子だけです。女子の全日本選手権もあるんですけれども、それは武道館ではやりません。
For example, if we consider the national tournaments for judo in Japan, the official national tournaments are only for the men's judo sports. There is a national women's tournament, however, this is not held at the Budokan, the main venue
すごく人気のある高校野球もなぜか女子高校野球はありません。
When we consider the extremely popular high school baseball as well, there is no such similar high school baseball for females.
そういうことを不自然だと思わない日本のスポーツの常識に対して、今回の霞ヶ関カンツリークラブの問題が表面化することによって、日本のスポーツ界全部が考え直すきっかけになればいいと、そういうふうに思って私は、この場に座らせてもらってますし、活動に参加させていただいています。
Therefore, when we consider the fact that such issues are within what is seen as common sense within the Japanese sports world, the fact that they are not even seen as something unnatural or which should be an issue is something that I hope the issue of the, or the issues raised by the Japan Golf Council can help to bring to the surface. And this issue of the Olympic golf venue can help to also change the way of thinking within the overall Japanese sports world. And this is the reason for me participating and being active here today.
So, thank you very much to all of our speakers. We'll now open the floor to questions. If I could just clarify my introduction first. Ms. Ohya is the chairwoman of the Japan Golf Council. Mr. Morohoshi is a vice chairman. Mr. Tamaki is also a vice chairman. Mr. Matsuzawa is a committee member of the council and also a member of the House of Councillors in Japan's Diet. So, if you have any questions about how this is playing out,in the diet, he can answer those. So if you could identify yourself to me, I can take your questions. Journalist first, please, then we'll open the floor to any other members of the club. Yes. If you can identify your affiliation.
シンガポープレスホーリー日本特派員のフと申します。私が知りたいのはこのキャンペーン の最もの趣旨なんですね。それは若さに戻したいためか、または霞が関を女性でも入れるようにしたいのか、ここをちょっとクリアしていただきたいし、あとは日本のオリンピックっていうのは意外と観光にすごく密着してますので、今回霞が関を選んだ理由の中にはそれが含まれているのではないか。例えば高級客を日本の一番ベストな カントリークラブを見せたいとかそういうこともあるんじゃないか、まあまあ、ここで話してきたいのはつまりその根本 の、 あの闇なところをもうちょっと具体的に言っていただきたいです。
I am from Singapore Press Holdings. I have two questions. The first is in regards to the main point or the fundamental purpose of your campaign. Are you looking at having the venue of the Olympics golf returned to Wakasu Golf Links, or is it that you are hoping for Kasumigaseki Country Club to open up full membership to women also? If you could clarify the main purpose for which you are calling. The second point is the Olympics in Tokyo are of course very closely connected to tourism as well. And I would like to ask whether you think that the tourism factor was also related to the decision to hold the Olympics golf at Kasumigaseki Country Club, for example, to be able to show these well-off visitors from other countries Japan's best country club, Japan's most prestigious country club, whether this was a factor.
主目的は、プレイヤーとか観客が苦しまないでもいいところに会場を変えた方がいいと思っていることで、女性問題は後からついてきた話で、例えば霞がね、あの理事会かなんか知りません、規約あれしてひょろっと変えてもう日曜日も女性ができるようにしますって言ったら、まあそれはそれで全然構わないですね。であのお金持ちの人を霞に連れて行きたいのではないかっていうお話がありましたけど、でもプレーはできないからね、知り合いメンバーの知り合いがいなかった、だからあんまり役に立たないんじゃないかなっていうふうに私は思います。
First of all, in regards to the primary purpose, we are hoping for a change of venue to somewhere which will mean that the players and the audience will not suffer during this time as well. The issue of discrimination against female women membership and so on actually came later or in addition on top of that issue. So if the Kasumigaseki Country Club were to change its regulations and so on to allow full female members, well, this is of course something which we would not say no to, but the main purpose is for looking at ensuring a comfortable venue for the sport. In regards to the second question about bringing well-off or rich people to Kasumigaseki, well, without the fact or considering the fact that they cannot actually play there without knowing a member, there is actually not much point to even bringing them there.
付け足して女性メンバーを OK にして、もしかしてでしょ、霞がパブリックにするとね、したとしても私は暑さの問題、遠い問題考えるとプレイヤーとか見に行く人にとってはそんなに別に良くはないっていう。
And to add, even if Kasumigaseki were to open up its doors to having a full membership for women, and also even if it were to make itself a public golf course, even then considering the distance and the heat and these factors as well, I don't believe it would be a very suitable venue.
Does anyone else on the panel wish to respond to that question?
That's fine.
You're fine? Okay. I have a question. I have two, actually. Is Mr. Abe a member of the Kasumigaseki Golf Club?
Abe-san?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
I do believe, however, there is one former prime minister who is a member.
Yeah.
I may be wrong. Don't quote me on that, but that's what I heard.
Okay. Right. Also, have you had any response yet from Mr. Back to the letter you filed?
We did not expect any response from him. It was just a matter of us bringing it up to his attention, and we expected him to take some action on it, and I think the action is really taking place, right? Sorry, Mayor.
Right.
Do we have any other questions from the floor? I can open it up to everyone on the floor. Yes, Mary? Oh, okay. The gentleman first, and then. Okay.
メリー・コルベット、と申します。クレスナーメディア、すいません、あのコストのお話も少し出ているんですけど、例えば首都高速に関してそのコストは例えば埼玉県持ちになるでしょうか。で、 小池百合子知事はどうお考えになっているかということと、それから障害者と女性に関しての問題で、もうすでにバックさんにお手紙を出しているということなんですけど、21世紀にアトランタが断念したことを21世紀に東京がやろうとするということは、少し世界的に大変大きな問題になると思うんですが、それはまだあまり日本国外には公表されてないから問題になってないんでしょうか。
My name is Mary Corbett. I have two questions. The first is in regards to the cost issue. There was discussion, for example, about the expressway having to be extended or special lanes and so on. I would like to ask, will this be covered, for example, by the Saitama government, or who would be responsible for such additional costs? Also in regards to whether Tokyo Governor Koike has also made some remarks or issue in regards to this. On the point about women or disabled people having access to this as well, I believe you have submitted the letter to Mr. Buck, the president of the International Olympic Committee. However, if we look at the fact that Atlanta in the last century gave up to hold the Olympics and Tokyo is now looking at, going forward with something which Atlanta had given up on, I think if we look at this globally, it could be quite a significant issue. However, in Japan, it is not really being raised in this way. If you could make a comment about that.
最初のポイントですけど、コストに関しては本当に首都高とですね、それから関越道のワンレーンをですね、オリンピックレーンとして借り上げるとすればですね、誰が試算してもですね、数億では効かないんじゃないかということであります。でそれを埼玉県が出すはずはないわけで、当然のことながら、オリンピックのですね、組織委員会といいますかの、もしくは東京とかでですね、出さないとですね、それは開催費用の問題でありますので、その費用の一部になるということになると思います。
First of all, in regards to the first point about the costs, if we consider the expenses which would be incurred by having to rent out a special lane within the Metropolitan and Kanetsu expressways, well, no matter who calculates this, we can say that it would be in the hundreds of millions of yen required for this purpose. There is no way that the Saitama government would offer to be able to pay these costs. Therefore, they would have to be absorbed by the Olympic Organizing Committee or also the Tokyo Metropolitan Government as the host of the Olympics.
松田さん、その辺。
参議院議員の松沢重文と申します。私はこのゴルフ会場の問題で国会で8回質問で取り上げてます。でその中の一つのポイントは、霞が関でやった時、開催した時と若洲で開催した時のコストの比較がね、できないかということで、何度も政府に組織委員会に問い合わせろと言ってるんですが、ずっと逃げて逃げて答えが出てきてません。でも比べてみると分かりやすいんですが、まず霞ヶ関はプライベートカントリークラブですから、1ヶ月以上ゴルフ場を休まなきゃいけないんで、ね、その保証料を払わなきゃいけないんです。でも若洲はパブリックコースで東京都が所有してますから、それはゼロですよね。まず会場費がかからないというのがあります。それから今度輸送費ですね。輸送費は先ほど諸星さん言ったように、まあ今考えているんですね、組織委員会では。例えばじゃあパトカー先導で
切って、
あ、どうぞ。Good afternoon. My name is Shigefumi Matsuzawa. I am a member of the Diet, and I have actually raised this issue of the golf venue 8 times within questions at the Diet until now as well. And the cost issue is very much one of the points for this. I have been repeatedly calling on the government to put forward a clear comparison of the cost which we would be involved in regards to holding the golf at Kasumigaseki or at Wakasu, and asking them to put this request to the organizing committee. However, they have been completely evading this issue and not given any response to this. However, when we do make a clear comparison, there is one point which is very significantly different between. When we consider the fact that Kasumigaseki Country Club is a private members club, it means that for 1 month their members would not have their fees and so on, or they would not be able to be using the venue there. Therefore, a rental fee would have to be paid by the organizing committee to Kasumigaseki for renting the golf course for this month. However, in comparison, Wakasu, because it is a public golf course, the rental fees incurred there are zero. And next, in regards to the transportation issue.
はい、で輸送費ですけれども、これ先ほどお話があったように、高速道路でワンレーン借り切るとなったら、高速道路会社に莫大な保証料を払わなきゃいけません。ですからこのお金どうするかっていうのがありますね。それから警備費も、遠くで孤立した場所でやると警官も含めてガードマンも含めてまたたくさん必要なんですね。 ね、ですからおそらく警視庁だけでは対応できないから埼玉県警にもお願いする、お金かかってきますよね。ところが若洲の場合は湾岸地域のオリンピックエリアでやるわけですから、隣はボート会場あるいは選手村も近い、こう一体の 面的な警備の中でやるんで警備コストもものすごく安いんです。で今オリンピックはこの前森組織委員長が発表しましたけれども、ね、1兆8000億ぐらいかかるって言ってるわけですね。でそのうちの施設費、施設を作ったりするお金は8000億で、1兆円はソフト経費なんです。そのソフト経費っていうのは警備費と輸送費とかね、こういうところですよ。ですから霞が関でやる場合どれだけのお金がかかるのか早く出せと言ってるのに、組織委員会は逃げ続けてるんですね。ですからこのコストの比較っていうのも、これから小池さんはコスト計算得意ですからね、これは小池さんにもしっかりとやっていただかないと、東京都や国がその分ボーンと負担が増えるわけですよね。はい。
And first of all, in regards to the transportation, if one single lane within the expressways would have to be rented exclusively for the purpose of transportation to the golf venue and so on, of course there would be a huge amount of cost incurred by this, which would need to be paid to the expressway operating company. Well, who would be responsible for this? As you say, this is one of the significant issues. Next is in regards to security. If the golf venue were to be held at this very distant, remote place, this of course means a significant increase also in the security costs. For example, the guards, the transportation and the cars and so on, which would be required for the travel time in regards to security as well. Of course, this could also not just be done by the Tokyo Metropolitan Police, but also the Saitama Police would have to be involved in this as well, which would also mean a significant further burden. If we compare this to the situation where if the golf were to be held at Wakasu, this is within the overall Olympics area within the Tokyo Central part. Right next to Wakasu is the boating venue, for example. It is also located very close to the athletes' village as well. So the fact that the venue would be within this overall Olympics area, which is already having the full security measures being put in place, means that there would be a significant difference in the cost regarded to this. Recently, the chair of the organizing committee, Mr. Mori, made an announcement about the estimations in regards to the costs for the Olympics of around 1.8 trillion yen at the time. Of this, around 0.8 was considered to be part of the hard facilities required for the Olympics, and around 1 trillion would be for the soft side of the infrastructure, including, for example, security and transportation and so on as well. Therefore, if we consider the scenario where the golf were to be held at Kasumigaseki, this would, of course, have a much higher cost in regards to this. Therefore, I have been calling repeatedly within the Diet for the government to put forward clear cost comparison in regards to this. However, they have continuously evaded this question. However, Governor Koike is, of course, very good at making such cost estimations and comparisons and so on as well. Therefore, I hope that we can continue to call on her and that she will be able to make some steps towards this.
Does anyone else have any response to that on the panel? Are you okay?
一ついいですか。
Yes, please.
アトランタがギブアップしたのと同じ条件でどうして霞が関がまた立候補したのかということですけど、それは決めた人たちが事情を知らなかったんだと思う。何を知らなかったかというと IOC の検証を知らなかった、オリンピックを何のためにするかということを知らなかった、ただ単にゴルフの大会を開くんだと思ったんですね。そこに一切の差別からの解放であるとか、あるいは平和運動であるとか、そういったことに対する意識は全くなかったと思いますね。
In regards to the question about why Kasumigaseki raised its hand to hold the golf, despite the fact that Atlanta had given up for the same reasons as well, I think that the clear reason for this is the people who were involved in the decision were just not aware of the facts. They were not aware of the Olympic Charter and the actual reason or the spirit of the Olympic Games itself. They just saw this as a golf tournament to be organized. So looking at the appeal about having no discrimination or the Olympics as a peace movement as well, this is something which they just had no awareness of.
もう一点ちょっと、
yes, please.
すみません。今霞が関で逃げ切ろうとしている人たちですね。もう変更なんかする必要ないと。この人たちがこういうことを言ってるんですね。今からじゃもう変更は間に合わないって言ってるんです。まあ、でも次の東京五輪までまだ3年以上あるんですね。3年半あるんです。それで。 私は例に使うのはリオのゴルフ場がですね、最初プライベートクラブで決まってたんですけども、まあやっぱパブリックの方がいいということで、ね、でパブリックコースがリオにはなかったんです。ですから実は新しいゴルフ場を沼地に作ったんですよ、ね、ゼロから。それが2年半でできてるんです。若洲はもうすでにゴルフ場として存在してるんですね。多少コースを長くしたり、あるいは松の木を切ってギャラリースタンドつけたり、こういう小さな改良は必要でしょうけども、ね、それに対するお金はほとんどかからないし、まだ3年半あるわけですから、十分若洲を改良して使うことは可能なのにね。もう今そのゴルフ霞が関で推進したい人たちはもう間に合わないから、もう時間切れだと、霞が関しかないんだと、こういう言い方もしてます。ですからここに我々は騙されてはいけないんだなというふうに思います。
One other point in regards to those people who are, well, evading these questions and trying to make sure that there is no change, that the golf continue to be held at Kasumigaseki. One of the reasons which they are bringing up is the fact that they say, well, there is no time left for a change of venue. It is too late to do that. However, that we still have over 3 years, 3.5 years until the Tokyo Olympics. And the example which I often raise is actually the example from the Rio Olympics. Initially, the golf venue for Rio was actually confirmed to be held at a private club. However, it was decided that this would not be suitable and that it should instead be held at a public club. However, there was actually no existing public golf club in Rio at the time, so they decided to construct a new golf club specifically for the purposes of the Olympics. This was built from zero in a marsh area in just 2.5 years. And the fact that this was actually possible to do in Rio, when we compared to Japan, in the situation in Tokyo where Wakasu Golf Links already exists as a golf course, it may need further extending, it may need further construction of a gallery, you know, chopping down some trees in order to build the audience stands and so on as well. However, with such small renovations, it would not require a huge amount of investment or money in order to do this, and we do have sufficient time to be able to go through with this as well. Therefore, those people who are saying that, well, Kasumigaseki is the only option because we have no time left, I would like to show that this is not the case at all.
もう一つ若洲に対しての反対意見の一つが、狭いということであります。で、狭いというのは例えばそのプレスコールのためのですね、プレスのためのそのエリアであるとかですね、それから練習場がないということなんですが、実は若洲の横にですね、もう何十年もずっと遊休地といいますか、そこでイベントなんか開いたことです。東映地、もちろん東映地です、はい、隣接したところがあります。でこれは大変広いところでありまして、ゴルフのホールでいうと4つか5つ分ぐらいのところがあります。それは十分使えますので、決して若洲が狭いからできないということもありません。
I would also like to raise one of the other reasons which those people who are opposed to changing the venue to Wakasu are often mentioning, is the fact that they see the area at Wakasu to be too small to be holding this. They raise the issue, for example, of an area for the press corps or also the practice area and so on as well. However, in fact, located right next to Wakasu, there is a metropolitan government-owned area of land which is used for events and so on, which could be actually utilized for the attached purposes in order to hold the golf at Wakasu.
We have time for one more question, if anyone. Otherwise, I'll take it. No? Okay. Mr. Matsuzawa, you explained that you raised this issue eight times. I beg your pardon. In the diet, could you just characterize, is there any sort of shift in the mood? Is people beginning to understand that this is an issue? And my second question to anybody is, how much would it cost to rent Kasumigaseki?
私は8回、もうこの1年半ぐらいにわたって国会で質問を続けてきてるんですね。で、歴代のオリンピック担当大臣、文部科学大臣、それから総理にも質問しました。でも、すべての大臣は、もうプロセスを経て決まったことですから、変更はできないと。いつか聞いたフレーズですよね。新国立競技場の時もずっとこう言ってたんです。ところがあまりにもコストがかかって、国民の不満が爆発したら、ごめんなさい、やっぱり一から全部見直しますってやったわけですね。ですから、政府っていうのはそういうところなんです。 プロセスで決まったのは変えられないってずっと言い続けて、でも国民の不満がたまって爆発しそうになると、まあ、このままじゃ選挙負けるな、じゃあやっぱりやり直そうってこう来るんですね。で今のところ政府の高官からは一切見直そうっていう意見は全くありません。もう紋切り型の一緒の答弁です。プロセスを経て決まったことですから、ね、それは組織委員会の決定を尊重します、変えるつもりはない。ところがですね、実はゴルフ改革会議で、3、4ヶ月前、実は IOC のバッハ会長とコーツ副会長に対してこのゴルフ場問題は絶対におかしいと、私たちはこう考えるという、まあ、要望書を送ったんですね、英文で、そうしたらばですね、その後なんか ずいぶん政治家の関わってる人の雰囲気が変わってきたんです。特に森会長の1月4日のコメント、霞が関で強行して大丈夫かと、ね、アクセスの問題とか、ね、いろんな問題があってもう一回検討し直した方がいいんじゃないかというコメントはですね、明らかに私たちが送った IOC への、まあ、要請の手紙を IOC 側が読んで、おいおい森さん、こんな手紙が日本から来たよと、大丈夫なのかいと、ね、特に女性差別の問題なんかは IOC の検証に、ね、反するわけですから、ちょっとじゃあそこまで。
So I have raised this issue on 8 occasions within the Diet within the past 1.5 years or so. I have raised the questions to the Minister for the Olympics, the Minister for Education and Sport, and also to the Prime Minister. However, the response that they always give, the unified response, is, well, this has been decided through a certain process, and so we will not be having any change of this. I think this is an answer which perhaps many of you are familiar with or have heard on other occasions, that is the National Stadium issue for the Olympics as well. Of course, this was raised as an issue. The same response was being held. However, as it became clearer and clearer that the costs were increasing to such an extent, and as the public's dissatisfaction with this issue really came to the fore, the government made the decision to make a change in this as well. This is really the nature of a government. They may not be wanting to make a change in this. However, if they can see people are coming to the point of really, almost exploding on an issue, they will see an impact potentially on elections and then take a step towards changing the situation as well. This was the case which we saw in the National Stadium. Therefore, we have seen very much the same voice coming from senior government officials, the same reprise about, well, we have gone through a certain process, this has been decided, this cannot be changed. However, just a few months ago, around 3 to 4 months ago, actually, when the Japan Golf Council submitted letters to Mr. Buck and also Mr. Coates of the International Olympic Committee in regards to the golf venue and making a request for consideration about this, we sent these letters to them in English. After this, we could actually see a change in the atmosphere of politicians on this issue. If we look at the comments made by Chair of the Japanese Olympic Committee, Mr. Mori, at the beginning of this year, on January 4, raising questions about, well, is Kasumigaseki really a suitable venue for the Olympics? The questions about access, and he also mentioned that perhaps it would be necessary to reconsider this venue. We can see very clearly that as a result of sending our letter to the IOC, perhaps this issue was raised with the senior Japanese officials in regards to this, and they therefore had a discussion and started to change their perspective about this.
すみません、もう少しだけ。その森発言とそれを受けて小池都知事の発言がありました。ね、女性を、ね、差別しているようなところでオリンピックやっていいのかしらってやつですね。まあ、これによってメディアもだいぶ報道が変わりまして、それで今私の予測ではオリンピック組織委員会内でもですね、もういろんな意見が出てきてるんだと思いますし、おそらくこれから霞ヶ関カントリークラブの理事会、こういうところでもおいこんなんでやっていいのかという意見が出てくると思いますし、実は国会議員もだいぶこの問題に気づき始めて、私のところにやっぱり松田さんの言う通りになるんじゃないかなんていう応援の声も入ってくるようになった。完全に潮目はですね、今年の正月から変わってます、変わりました。ですから、まあ、メディアの皆さんがこれを、ね、広く国民の皆さんに報道していただけると、その矛盾に国民の皆さんが気づいて大きな声になって政治が動くという方向に持っていけると私は期待してるんですね。
Therefore, we have seen, for example, the comments by Mr. Mori. This was also followed by comments by Governor Koike, also questioning whether an Olympic venue should really be held somewhere where there is discrimination against women. Following these two senior officials' comments, there has been quite a change in the way the media is reporting this issue as well. I expect that there is also going to be discussion within the Japanese Olympic Committee in regards to this as well, and also within the board at Kasumigaseki Country Club as well. Following these developments also, I believe that many members of the Diet have begun to notice this issue or see it as well. They have been contacting my office, for example, and saying, Mr. Masuzawa, this is exactly as you have been mentioning as well, and expressing their support for the questions I have been raising as well. This whole change in the wind has really just happened since the beginning of this year, since the new year as well. Therefore, I would like to also call on the members of the media in reporting this to the public as well, about the fact that, well, public, as they start to notice that this is indeed an issue and notice these contradictions which are involved in this. This is what is required to change politics as well, and I have great hopes for this.
Okay, we have to finish there, and I have a very welcome announcement I'd like to make, is that the FCCJ is a members club that practices no discrimination whatsoever. And so I'm very honored to offer, first of all, Ms. Ohya, a one-year honorary membership of the FCCJ. Thank you very much. And to all of our other panelists here as well, you have a one-year membership. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Could I offer our thanks to Mary Joyce? Just fantastic translations. Yes. Just absolutely. Very good. Thank you. Absolutely perfect. Yeah, perfect.